Let's zoom back to finite state machines at 88 miles an hour. Here's a finite state machine that corresponds to the regular expression a plus 1 plus. Let's just verify that by tracing out the input AA1 on this finite state machine. We start in the start state, we haven't seen anything yet, we see the A, whoop, we're in state 2, we see the A, self-loop back to state 2, we see the 1, we're in state 3, oh, state 3 is an accepting state, huzzah! Surprisingly, this super high-tech sounding trace it with my finger approach is actually pretty much exactly what computers do under the hood to check strings against regular expressions or evaluate finite state machines. You really only have to keep track of where you are in the input and which state you're in, and not much else. So let's do this together. We'll write a computer program in Python to check to see if a finite state machine accepts a string. So if I somehow give it this finite state machine and AA1 as input, it should say true. If I instead give it AA1B, it should say false, because that string is not accepted. But the first big design decision is, how do we represent this finite state machine? By now, we know how to pass a Python program a number or a string or a list, but how do I pass in a picture? Well, for the states, 1, 2, 3, presumably I could just pass in a list of the states. It's these edges, these arrows that go anywhere. That's what really matters. What we really want to know from an edge is, if I'm in state 1 and the next input is A, where do I go? So let's use Python dictionaries or maps to do this. I'll make a Python dictionary or map called edges, and I'll just pass in my current state and the input letter, and it will give me the new state at the end. Before we dive into it though, let's have a little refresher on maps and also tuples. You may have seen them before in a previous CS class, but if you haven't, I'll just go over them right now. You make a new map or dictionary in Python using open curly braces and close curly braces, and the purpose of a map is to associate one thing with another. For example, here I'm making a map that's going to help me keep track of which things in the world are flowers, because I might easily forget this critical knowledge. So I can update my map by saying, roses should map to true in the isFlower dictionary, but dog is not a flower, so that should map to false. And then if I go look it up later, isFlower of rose will return true. There's an alternative notation for specifying a map. Inside the curly braces you use to make a new map, you can actually just put all of the bindings. Rose maps to true, colon. Dog maps to false. There's a colon in the center. Now at this point, you're probably thinking, what's in a name? Is this word rose really important? Or would a rose by any other name still smell as sweet? Well, we may be able to tell synonyms, but Python cannot. So if I try something like isFlower Juliet, that's not defined in this mapping. So we will get some sort of key error or element not found exception. For Python dictionaries, you need to get the name exactly right. Dictionaries and mappings are synonyms. They both refer to the same thing. A Python tuple is just an immutable list. Immutable means you cannot change it. Once you make it, it is etched in stone. For example, I could make a tuple to hold the Cartesian coordinates of some object. Maybe my point on the grid is at 1, 5. I can access its elements the same way I would for a list. The 0th part of point is 1, the 1th part of point is 5. And while Cartesian points may not be super exciting, many of you may have done navigation or taken long trips and used GPS coordinates or longitude and latitude. The Taj Mahal is a UNESCO World Heritage Site in India. These are its actual GPS coordinates. Go check it out.